back to the RJ.
Okay, it's 10 a.m. 50 seconds GST.
That is Gurukul Standard Time.
Yes, thank you. RJ Sarav, but more importantly, it is time for our next feature on JNR. We have an interview with a dancer who is a world famous for her hip-hopping skills, showcased by her periodic shows on and off the main stage.
Giving you Shrutika Raftogi, wife of Raju Raftogi. She will be interviewed by the eccentric Sudhesh Rangade.
One and all listening to JNR 92.1 10 FM. I am Sudhesh Nanade, and today on our show we have the famous dancer Shrutika Raftogi, wife of Raju Raftogi. Let's give her a big hand. So welcome to our show, Miss Raftogi.
Thank you. It's a great pleasure to be present with the JNR team. I have always loved this radio channel and have been listening to it ever since I was 14.
Well, what is your age, ma'am? Because our show isn't that old, you see. Well, let me guess. Are you around 54 years old? It has been approximately 40 years since the show started.
Oh God, no, I'm not. Do I even look that old? I'm just 34.
Sorry, ma'am. Well, how many years have you been married to Mr. Raju Raftogi?
We've been married for 5 years now. But I never seem to believe that, as he is generally not at home. I have to live all alone most times of the year.
Really? Well, that is sad. But why is it so? I thought he was a really good and caring husband, but now I'm beginning to guess that it wasn't that way. I'm sure our audience wants to know more about this spicy news that you've just revealed.
Well, he's either shooting for a movie outside hometown, or else he's on his search for his old beloved friend Rancho. I am so tired of him. But one good thing is that it's only because of him that I'm such a famous dancer, and that I have been able to earn well enough and support myself.
And how is that so?
As he was working in the film industry, the industry recognized me. And once you're recognized in the Bollywood industry, you have a good life ahead.
Very true. Even I had a friend of mine who... Oh, never mind. Well, that I must say is quite interesting. So tell me, what is it like to be Raju Raftogi's wife?
There's nothing very special about it. He's just a normal person when he's home. But he's generally never home. So I don't feel much like a married woman.
Well, at least you don't have husband-wife quarrels.
That is what everyone thinks, but it's not so at all. Whenever he comes home, he starts fighting and arguing about one or the other little thing. It is so annoying. I guess all husbands are the same.
Well, I don't think a normal person would take so much of nonsense. Anyways, tell me why you chose such an unusual career.
I was never very good in studies. In fact, I was horrible. I loved dancing and my family was very supportive. They always said that I could go in any field I wanted to. But if I ever told anyone else that I wish to become a dancer when I grew up, they would either laugh it out, give me a disgusted look, or ask me how I will earn if I became a dancer. Some would even say, engineer ban ja, ye sab karne se kuch nahi hoga.
Well, that would have been a typical scenario. People always recommend careers where there's money, not joy. How did you cope up with it?
Actually, that was the hardest part. My mother always told me that I should listen to them. If I know what I'm doing and I'm sure about doing it for the rest of my life and I'm passionate about it, I should very well give it my best without thinking of any other creature on earth except myself.
Oh, that's interesting. And it is no surprise to all of us that this hardworking woman has finally achieved success.
Yep, and I'm very happy with what I'm doing.
Thanks very much for being on our show, Ms. Raftogi. It has been a pleasure to have you here.
Thanks to you too.
Well guys, we learned two new things today. The first, if you're confident about what you want to do in life, you will achieve it. And the second, Raju Raftogi is a pathetic husband. Well, that's all folks. And the next time we'll hear about the life of another famous personality. Alright, back to RJ Alok.
Thanks, Sudhesh. I guess we've got a good character sketch of Mr. Raftogi.
Now I feel like jumping a bit.
Sarang, it's on radio, not video, so no one can see.
Oh man.
But something you can do is to inform our faithful supporters about the next program.
Right, good idea. We have, only on 92.10 FM, JNR, a multi-topic quiz. Our conductor for this is PhD, MSc, Doctor, Professor Siddharth Bamle.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to Who Wants to Be a Loser? A Millionaire. This is the first time that a reality show has been broadcasted on radio, courtesy JNR 92.10 FM. We have with us Mr. Gaurav Dhiman. A big hand to him, please. He is an aeronautical engineer from Pune and wants to go to NASA for further studies. He's already won ₹1. A huge round of applause, please. So, Mr. Gaurav, tell us about your ambitions for those who missed the previous episode.
My first ambition is...
Excuse me. Thank you.
Please talk softly and try not to spit on the mic. My first ambition is to study at NASA and build a rocket which goes at nearly the speed of light.
Speed of light? Wow. I don't remember you telling this. I hope you'll not get sick by sitting in a rocket going at such speeds. Anyway, the next question is for ₹5. And here it is. Name the goddess of Greek mythology who served nectar to the gods on Mount Olympus. Your options are A. Iris, B. Rhea, C. Hestia, and D. Hebe. What do you think, Gaurav?
It is not Rhea, because my gut feeling says so.
Okay, go on.
Then Iris, Hebe, sir, I would like to use a lifeline.
Certainly. Which one would you like to use?
Expert's advice.
Alright then. Computer, Gaurav wants to use a lifeline expert's advice. Our expert for today is the famous actress Sanjali Soonyavanshi. A big round of applause for her, please. So, what do you think, Ms. Soonyavanshi?
Iris is the messenger of gods. Hestia is the goddess of birth. Rhea was Zeus' mother. And Hebe is the goddess of youth. And the nectar should be served by youth. So, it is D, Hebe.
Thank you, Sanjali, for that advice. So, Gaurav, Sanjali says it should be D. Hebe.
Yeah, I would like to go with the expert, sir. D. Hebe.
Okay. Computer, please lock D. Hebe. Is the right answer. A huge round of applause, please.
So, I was very nervous, sir.
I know. Look at your face. It's covered with sweat.
Yes, sir.
Do you know why you are sweating?
Is this the next question?
No, it's because the sweat glands are connected to the nerves by the brain and... Oh, so...
Good night, sir.
Why?
Never mind. Can we continue the show, please? I have a meeting in 10 minutes with an alien.
An alien? Really? So do extraterrestrials exist?
No, sir. I was just joking. It is a CEO of a hostile company. But please, could we get on with it?
Oh, sorry. So you're on ₹5. The next question is for 10 crore. You have 2 lifelines left. So here it comes. What is the color of a newborn zebra? Your options are A. Brown, B. Black, C. White, or D. Pink.
Sir, it is definitely not black, sir.
Oh, okay, go on.
But then, sir, I would like to use a lifeline. Phone a friend lifeline.
Definitely. Computer, Mr. Gaurav wants to use his second lifeline. Phone a friend. So, Gaurav, whom do you want to call?
Rajas Orpe.
Oh, is he that fellow who has the Guinness World Record of eating Rajma?
No, sir. I don't think so.
Oh, anyway, computer, please call Rajas Orpe.
Hello.
Mr. Rajas Orpe, this is Siddharth Damle from Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
Oh, sir, it is great to talk to you, sir. I'm a big fan of yours, sir.
I see. It's great to talk to you too. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Do you know the world record Rajma eater Rajas Orpe?
What? That's me, sir. How do you know? But why, sir?
Oh, never mind. Anyway, your friend Gaurav Dhiman is here now, playing for ₹10 crore. He will read out the question. You have only 30 seconds to answer. Here is Gaurav. Your time starts now.
What is the color of a newborn zebra? Your options are A. Brown, B. Black, C. White, D. Pink.
Sorry, the record is battling. Could you repeat it?
What is the color of a newborn zebra? Your options are A. Brown, B. Black, C. White, D. Pink.
Okay, I think it is A. Brown.
Oh, are you sure?
60%.
Oh God, alright, thanks.
And the time's up. So, what do you think?
Sir, it's A. Brown.
Is that your final answer?
Yes, sir.
Computer, please rock A. Brown. You are playing for 10 crore rupees. If this is a wrong answer, you go back to rupees 0.5. What do you think?
I should be right.
It is absolutely right. A huge round of applause for him. Well played. You have won rupees 10 crore. A huge round of applause again. The crore will be given to the society for charity.
Oh, I'm so rich now. I can go to NASA now. Thank you so much, sir.
Yes, yes.
I can't believe it. It's amazing.
Oh God, someone take this madman out.
Oh, it's incredible.
That was close. So, who's going to be our next 10 rupee, oh sorry, I mean 10 crore conditions apply winner? Keep listening and remember to tune in at the same time next week on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Back to JNR.
We're back again, guys. Now, the next awards. Now is the award for the most updated website in 9th Nanishwar. The nominations are Gasp, which is made by our computer freaks Gaurav, Aditya, Sarang and Parth. High Five, which is used for uploading photos. And Twitter, the twittering website. And the winner is...
The award for the most updated website in 9th Nanishwar goes to Gasp.
Next is the award for the most wanted subject. I think it is too obvious. Still, the nominations are PE, PD and Yoga. The winner is...
The award for the most wanted subject in 9th Nanishwar goes to PE.